Srivalli. I am pursuing Masters of Social Work, second year. I am from Rhoda Mistry College. I am studying in the Rhoda Mistry College of Social Work and Research Center. I want to talk about one thing, that is the child abuses. The main topic is now we are seeing in everywhere in the world. So I want to discuss about that, child abuse. Abuses will be not only happen for only girls who are above the majors, that is above the 18 years. The child, they doesn't know anything. Like we being the parents or being the teachers or the elders, they will teach to the children how they are and what they should do. So the children, they are in the learning stage. Abuses. In that abuse, I want to focus one thing, that child doesn't understand what is right and what is wrong. Every parent and the child should make them to understand what is meant by abuses also. These can be happened in any ways, from any person. We can't tell them that abuse will happen only from the outside persons or the outside one. It can be happened in the within the society where they are living, within the house where they are living in it. So we should focus. In every school, they should focus on safe and unsafe touch. They should teach about that. What is meant by safe touch? What is meant by unsafe touch? How they should protect their own body? It makes the sense of children to think about it, to explore them in a positive way. So, and one more thing, not only for the girls, the abuses can happen for the boys too. But the boys will not come into an society and they will think that I am the boy, abuse will not happen to me. But it's absolutely wrong. When you go and visit in the community, you can see each and every cases is that abuses will happen for the boys too. If you search in the Google or the YouTube for the abuses for the boys from the tuition, sir, or from any kind of friends or anything, that will be happen for the boys too. So my suggestion is that one thing, that safe and unsafe touch should be taught for both boys and the girls in every school and the colleges, so that the parents also will able to understand what happening in the society. Oh, like this we are happening in the society. And one more thing, when we taught for the children, they will come and explain, they will come and share with the parents, mama, this thing will happen to me. Abuses will not have, sexual harassment will not have in the once thing. The very few cases will happen in a sudden or something. But abuses and violence will take place from starting, like they will plan it. They will first, they will be normal. They will be like a uncle or anyone. They will be normal. They will not tell anything. They will be closed with the kids and they will give chocolates, they will give anything. We will think that uncle is taking care of the kids. But in the real thing, when parents are not there, the uncle or any person that who is close to the family also, they can also abuse the child. But child is unable to express it. That's the main thing. Why? Because they will be in a confused mode. Uncle, they are very close to me. They are very, they known to my family. How the child will be in a confused mode and he will not able to, he will or she will not able to express it. They will be in a fear mode. May they also get it like threatening to them that if you told the person who is abuser, he may threat that if you tell to your father or your mother or your sister, I will kill them or I will punish them, or the child will afraid. So parents should keep eye on them. Except them, nobody can really be with the children 24 hours. Even they go for the schools also, they come back and they will stay at home. And the teachers also should be observe how child is behaving in everyday school, so that they can think about it and they can observe the cases over there. Why I focus, we are as a social work student, when we visited to a community, we'll see lot of cases related to the child abuses. So I hope everyone will think about this issue and go through about it. Thank you so much.